Now I will explain Pelton turbine. See, for Pelton turbine, I will show you our one is, this will be used for the generation of the power. The power generation, that is, in India we are using the power is generated by the hydro power station. One of the power station, you can see here, the water will be there. This is called the reservoir, water will be filled, and this is called the spillway, the excess water will be going. But along the dam, here at the bottom, you can see the control, the intake structure, and this is called the penstock. The water which is having with high pressure will be more than 10 meters will be there, water will be rushing here. And we are having turbine. With high speed, water will be hitting the impact object through the wall, so that the turbine will rotate and the mechanical energy will be converted into electrical energy. How this pressure will be coming is, we are using the hydrogen, that is natural atmospheric pressure will be there, water will be pressed by the atmospheric pressure and water will be pressing there. And excess, once the after the water is turbine, it comes to rotation, the excess water or the mechanical energy water will be thrown out to the river. And you can see that one more is, you can see at the top, we are having the spring bay on the top of the dam, and you can see the reservoir, pet stop, gantry gate, dam. This will be dam portion, but actually the main purpose of the dam is only to use the spillway of the excess water. But whatever the water is stored in the dam, it will be used for the power generation. In India or throughout the world, the power generation is being starting, it will be done by the water only, by the construction of the dams. The dam is being used for the multi-purpose. We are using for the both for irrigation, power generation, drinking water, and also for the including navigation or for fishing. Here the main purpose of our tell you about the, here we are using for the power generation. The hydropower is one of the oldest source of energy that is used thousands of years ago to turn the paddle of the wheel. Not only for here, earlier this system is being used to the irrigation also. And the purpose of grinding the grain, even this was being used for the grinding of the grain also, the water has been used. This he explained, now also you can see this in the Rajasthan where we are having that one. And mechanical energy is derived by directing the handlers or charging moving water. The amount of available energy in moving water is determined by its flow or the fall. How much water is flowing? It can be determined by the flow, but by using simple. Shifting flow of water is a big river carrying into a great deal of energy in its flow. So, with water descending rapidly from a very high point, because you know, water descending from a very high point, in either instant or through a flow of pipe, this is the flow of pipe. We are having the penstock. The pushes the against the turbine blades. It pushes against the turbine blades, the turbine. It pushes. And spin the water, it spin. Once it is spinning, we are having, because of spinning, we are having the, you are studying in your electrical, because of we are having the copper with the magnetic, the power is being generated. And the water is accumulated reservoir can be, and the water which is accumulated can be used for the generation of the power. Then they release water into the dam for the electricity. More the speed, the more the efficiency, the number of, the more rotation is given, with higher speed, the more power will be generated. For that, we are having the intake structure, control valve. So how much you want to control, whether you want to control full valve, you can control the valve, and this pipe is called the penstock, and it is called the turbine. And we are having the outflow, when the water is moving, we are having outflow. And also we are having, this is shown, we are showing the impact, how it will be there. It is a gravity dam, that means water will flow through the gravity only. And it is in arch, this is the different shape of the arches, will be there for the butterfly arch. But the main purpose is to generation of the power. To start with the experiment, we are having the collection tank. This is the tank we are having. This is the drum to denote the, to put the load we are having. And water will be flowing. Your venturi meter, the how much quantity discharge is there. Then we are having the jet. See, water will be flowing here. Actually, this is what we are taking. But in the real experiment I showed now, it will be coming from the very height. And water will come with very, the jet is there. It will hit this bucket. So when the water hit this bucket, it rotates with very high velocity. When it is rotating with very high velocity,
the power, the mechanical energy is converted, the kinetic energy is converted, the mechanical energy to the electrical energy. So the electrical energy is there and the excess water will be both there. To know the speed, the starting the whatever the speed you want to know, will be keep on putting the load. Once the load will be coming, the load will be, the speed will vary. So we are having the 3D, P1, P2 and H. And to know the how much RPM, here the readings will be coming regularly. Pass mode.
Okay, good morning all. My I am Deepika R, currently working as an assistant professor in the civil department, RR Institute of Technology. So today we are going to explain regarding the Kaplan turbine experiment. So I'll be explaining what are the components of the turbine, how this works, what will be the efficiency when this Kaplan turbine is applicable. Okay, so you people can see here. So this is the setup of the Kaplan turbine. So this one will act as a temporary reservoir. There are three different types of turbines we already know. First one is a Pelton turbine, the second one Francis turbine, and the last one is a Kaplan turbine. Okay, Kaplan turbine is a low head turbine. Even when you have very low amount of the water, like 20 to 30 meter water is available, then also you can use this Kaplan turbine. Okay, that is the main advantage. Efficiency is not high as that as you compare to Pelton, but it's a low cost, and for a very low head also it will be working. No, so it is like more economical one. So as I said, this is a temporary reservoir. It will act as a water stored water. So you people can see here, there's a motor is given this side. From the reservoir, the motor is going to draw the water through this pipe. Okay, this will act as a penstock here. From this, the connection is given. This is a pipe which is drawing water towards the turbine. Okay, see, in this pipe there is a portion given. Can you see this red color? So this red color portion is a venturi meter. I want some measurement, right? How much water is running towards the turbine actually? So this concept is mainly based on the water power or else hydraulic power. Okay, so how much water is running, that is also we want to measure. So that is the reason venturi meter is given here. With what pressure it is running, for that manometers are connected. You people can see here these two pipes. So this is the inlet portion and this is throat. This one is divergent portion. Always we have to measure the pressure at inlet and throat. Divergent, it's gonna release water, no need of measuring any pressure. Okay, this is the portion where actual pressure will be there. So this will act as a P1 and this will be P2. Remember the notations. So venturi meter is given in order to calculate discharge and velocities. Okay, so this will be these two are the manometer pipes. This will give you pressure at inlet and this one will give you pressure at throat portion, P1 and P2. So this portion is done. Now I will move on. You people can see this valve, this black color one. So this is a discharge control valve. So some amount is running, but what amount is running I want to control, right? So discharge control valve is given over here. By using this you can control, like when you're finding efficiency, for 30% we'll do 60%, 90%, what is eta value, that calculation will be doing. No, for that purpose this valve is given. Done. So next you move on. As you move on, you see this blue color one, this is a casing. So this is the casing pipe, it's given here. You people can see this. This side. Okay, this is a casing pipe. Okay, see the dimension. It's a bigger at the initial or at the starting position. It's very bigger. As it moves in, you can see the dimension is reduced. That means it's like a spiral. Okay, one more name for the Kaplan turbine is horizontal turbine, and the vertical will be in vertical shaft will be in vertical direction. So inside the casing pipe valves will be given. Okay, So regarding the turbine, if you want to learn more theory part, please go to module 4 in applied hydraulics. So you'll be getting all these components, instruments, working, everything you are going to get. So I'll be explaining some little bit points here. So within the casing pipe, what we have done, we have fixed valve. There are two types of valve, outer valve and inner valve. Okay, so whatever the water is going to enter like this, that will drop down like this, straight it's going to drop down. Okay, if your water is dropping like this, we can say it axial. So one more name for the Kaplan turbine, we can also give it as axial flow turbine. It's because when water is entering here, it will drop exactly like this. Okay, in a vertical direction it is going to drop. On what it is going to drop? On the valves it will be dropping. Done? So you can you see this? I do zoom on it. Can't see there. So this glass tube is there, no, here. Within that glass tube, there is a small portion, black color's small portion is there. That one we'll be calling it like hub or boss. The name is hub or boss. Diagram I'll show you. You keep this in mind. Next to the valve, hub or boss will be located. And next to that, this pipe will be located. So this is the outlet pipe given. We'll also call it like draft tube. The size is increased because while dropping down, it should not damage the lower portion of the ground, or the soil should not erode. That is why this draft tube dimension is increased gradually. Okay, so this is about the components. The next one is, can you see this wheel, the bigger one? The bigger one is a runner. Okay, this will allow you to measure the readings, the spring balance reading and how much weight we are giving. That one will allow us to take the reading. So this is the runner and this portion is a shaft. So how shaft is located? Your whole turbine or a casing is a horizontal position and exactly perpendicular to it, shaft is located. Okay, the main concept we already know, no? So conversion of water power to mechanical power, from mechanical power to here dynamo will be connected, from that they will be extracting electric power. That connection is not here, and this green color pipe is given. Can you people see this green color pipe and the red color one? So these two are the breaking jets. Sometimes here it is a small experiment, it is fine, but if you imagine near the dam sites or a very big hydraulic structures, even if you stop the machine, sometimes your runner will be keep on running because that much energy you have already given to that. So to stop that running position, what they will do, we will be putting water in opposite direction. That means we are going to break the movement. So that is why these two pipes are given here. So taking the reading and all, I'll show you now. So for this, first one is a capital letter P we have written, that means overall head. Reservoir I have shown, no, the tank. For that reading you are going to get here, and P1, P2 near the venturimeter connection, two pipes I have shown. Those two you are going to get reading here. And this one is for speedometer. I'll just run the machine so that you will be getting. There are two concepts. One is constant head and another one is constant speed. Okay, I'll show you how constant speed will work first, and then we'll move on to constant head. See, for the first reading, I'm going to show constant speed now. There are two cases, as I said. Constant speed, that means you are going to make the speed as constant and noting down rest of other three readings. Okay, I'll be keep this as 600 rpm. Okay, you keep the 600 rpm, note down P1, P2. Calculations I'll show you later. So that is a concept we are doing, constant speed. I'm going to keep this rpm as 600. For that, I'll be noting down rest of the readings. Okay. So first trial will be, I'm taking 2 kg weight. I'll be putting here. This is your. There are 3 trials you have to do. First one, 2 kg, 4 kg, and 6 kg. So this is my first trial. As I said, this is a discharge controlling valve, right? So how much you want, you can keep. I'm going to show the calculations for Kaplan turbine now. See, all these datas D1, D2, A1, A2, they'll be standard readings, okay? So, dynamometer reading is also standard. It will be given for you people. So, what is our final unknown? Final unknown, we are finding efficiency. Efficiency is nothing but output by input. This is what we are doing here, okay? For the calculation of the output, one formula is given here. 2 pi N T by 60,000. 60,000 is a conversion. 60 into the reading. It's in a watt here. So that is why 60,000 is just you keep as it is, standard formula. So W minus S, weight of the weight, how much you are putting for an individual. I shown no 2 kg, 4 kg, 6 kg. That one it is. So spring balance reading, you are going to get that. You just assume the spring balance reading like 0.5 for all the trials. You just assume the spring balance reading as 0.5. The weight, it will be varying 2, 4, 6. Hanger weight, it will be given for you people. Weight of the hanger is 1 kg standard into 9.81 into, so it's not that, 9.81, that's it. So once you got the T value, you can substitute here, right? So what about N? N is an RPM, speed. We have set it 700, right? So that reading you are going to substitute here. So next one I want is input. So input will be WQH. So what is W? Specific gravity of the water. So specific gravity of the water, how much gravity? It's 1000 into 9.81. So you're going to get 9810. So substitute that, you'll be getting input also. So I'll be moving on to tabular column directly. See, as I said, there are two cases. One is constant head, another one is constant speed. So first I'll tell you constant head. So what is this? pressure pipe, sorry, constant speed, no, we have done, sorry. So constant speed here, they made it as 900. Just now, I just took it for 700, okay? So same thing, set it for 900. The first one, head on the turbine, that means it's a capital letter P. First reading I have shown, no, that one. So corresponding readings you have to take. What is this? For 2 kg first trial, 4 kg second trial, and for 6 kg third trial. So this one, S value we are going to assume here. So P, P1, P2, you will be getting there. Okay, so in the same way, constant head also we can do. Constant head means what? Head means capital letter P, overall head. So P value you make it like 1 and note on other 3 readings. It is simple. Once you got this reading, you can move on here. Find out the discharge. Torque formula I have shown. Output input formula is there. So find out efficiency. So NS, NU, they are the unit speed and unit discharge values. These are not required. You keep up to efficiency. Okay, these things are not required for you people. So up to efficiency we'll be doing. For output, input, everything, formula is there. You have to substitute. While finding the discharge, this discharge you are going to get from venturi meter. Okay, this is the standard venturi meter formula, right? It is. So A1, A2, H, everything will be given in the standard. That pick I'll show you for you people. So that's it. So Kaplan turbine, mainly there are 2 conditions you have to do, constant head and constant speed. Once you get that, you have to plot a graph between efficiency versus discharge to check how much the efficiency you are going to get. So in the previous thing, they got the efficiency like 65%, but usually the efficiency of a Kaplan turbine, like in a laboratory experiment, it will not go up to 40%, even 40% only. Okay, fine. Thank you. I'll just send that standard pics and all.